Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines had been dormant for 600 years. Even when it started rumbling in 1991, few had any idea how dangerous it was. One day later, Pinatubo blew its top. But this explosion was minor compared to what followed 3 days later.
I went outside the hangar and turned around and looked, and all of a sudden, it looked like, I guess you would describe it as the mountain range exploding from left and right.
This was the second biggest eruption of the 20th century. The ash cloud turned day into night.
Well, it was just dark, dark, dead, hard storm in the middle of the night, no lights at all, dark.
It's a feeling you can't really describe when the sun, you can't see, you know you're supposed to have sunlight, and everything is dark, and yet you're getting all this mud and stuff on you. I thought that this is it. This is it. This is the big one.
At midday, it was more like midnight for miles around. Ash clouds from volcanic explosions can completely block out all daylight. But these terrifying phenomena can have far-reaching and more damaging effects. The ash from the cataclysmic eruption of Mount Pinatubo shot more than 20 miles into the stratosphere. In less than a month, it circled the globe. Eventually, ash particles drifted across the entire planet and reflected so much sunlight back into space, it lowered global temperatures for at least 2 years.